Today, I'm going to take you through the setup and startup of Google Docs and Google Gmail for a brand new user here at PLC. So I'm on the Enable front page here. In the new Enable next year, we will have a button on the front page here somewhere. I don't know exactly where it will be. At the moment, we've got a little sort of button. If you scroll down the page a little bit here, you see it says the Google Early Adopters. You can click on this even if you're not an early adopter. And click on the Google logo, and it will take you to this login page right here. So you can see I've been logging here before, but I have created a dummy user called Dami User. So I've given her the username DUSER, and her password is that. So I'm just going to click the button and say sign in. By the way, try and put the correct password in. You can actually click this stay signed in button and you will stay signed into the service. Okay, so I'm now logging into my brand new account, never been here before. Before I do anything, you see there's a button at the top here that's popped up in Chrome that says save password or don't save password, never for this site. I am going to suggest you save your password. That way you won't have to put it in every single time you log on. Some of you might be wondering, is that safe? Well, don't forget, you've got to log into the computer to get to this page in the first place. So if someone can get into Chrome and into your Gmail, they will have already gotten through your network password. So yes, I think it's probably pretty safe. Click the Save Password button. Now it will remember me from now on. Because it's a new account, I get this page just welcoming me to my new account. And I have to click this Accept button down here and continue to my account. You may sometimes get a thing called a CAPTCHA, which is those funny letters. You have to type in the letters that are hard to read. That's a security thing. Not everybody gets those. But if you do, just add the letters. All right, and we're logging in for the very first time. And here we are. We're now logged into Gmail. And I want to take you through the typical things that you do as a new user to set up. And the first thing you'd want to do is probably change your password. So up here in the top corner, you'll see here it says your email address. So I've got Dami User up here. And if I click on that email address, a box will pop down and I have the option to go to account settings. So let's do that. And on the account settings page, I have the option here to change my password. So I'm just going to change my password to something that I can remember. So I need to put in the old password. Hopefully I typed that correctly. And a new password, I'm going to use that. And again, a second time. And say save. Passwords need to be at least 8 characters. And it tells me there that the password has been saved. So that's great. Okay, I can not worry about that. And I will go now back to my mailbox. Now, the sensible thing to do at this point would be to log out. And you can do that again by clicking up here on the username and saying sign out and then simply coming back in here again with your new password. I'm not going to do that for this demonstration, but that's obviously, you know, a good idea to do that, to log out and log back in with your new password to make sure it works. All right, let's have a little look. Now, Gmail recently changed the look and feel of their email. And you'll probably have this button down the bottom of the screen here that says switch to the new look. And I recommend you do that. It's a lot cleaner, the new look. So I'm just going to click this switch to the new look. It's going to give me a couple of pages here. Yes, I do want to switch to the new look. So I'll click this button here. And it goes away and has a little think. And it will actually log me in again a second time. And this time it will log me in with the new look. Okay, so it's saying welcome to the new look. Yes, I want to continue to the new look. And here we go. So it doesn't look a whole lot different, but it is definitely cleaner and you'll find your way around a lot easier with this new look. All right, let's set up a couple of things. Before we do, just take a look up here. We've got on the side here, you've got your links to mailboxes, much like you did in Outlook. Over here, you've got the actual messages themselves. So you can see if I click on this message, it opens up and shows me there's the message there. Okay. And if I want to get rid of it, I can just click this back button here and go back to the inbox. I can tell which messages are red or not red because the unread ones are in bold. Red ones are not in bold. So it's pretty easy to tell what's been read. You might be wondering, there's normally a panel over here on the right side of the screen in Outlook. We can put that in here, so I'll show you how to do that. We're going to spend a few moments going through settings, and you get them by clicking on this little wheel in the corner here and going down to where it says mail settings. So So just click on Mail Settings, and it will take us to the setup page. Okay, so here we are at the setup page. Now, you can go through here and read these at your leisure and turn on or off whatever you would like, because it's your email. Make it behave any way that makes sense to you. A couple of things I will suggest to you you probably should do. Unless you like American English, you can click on this and change it to UK English, and then you'll get all the British spelling that we use here in Australia. Maximum page size is the number of email messages you'll see per page, and I would recommend you set that to the highest, because we all tend to get a lot of mail, so set it to 100, and that's fine. Keyboard shortcuts are a good idea to have. Whether you decide to use them or not is up to you, but it's a good idea to turn them on. So we'll click that to on, and we'll take you through the rest. I think, yes, leave this external content to always display. Always use HTTPS. That keeps your mail secure, and it encrypts your mail from end to end. There's a conversation view where Gmail will group your messages together where they have the same subject line. I'm going to recommend you turn that on. You can always come back and turn it off if you don't like it, but it's a great idea, and you'll probably fall in love with it once you use it. So leave that on. You can star things. In Outlook, you might remember you had the ability to put a little flag next to a message. Well, here you can star things. You can use one star, four stars, or all the stars. And, of course, if you decide you don't want some of these particular icons, you can just take them from the bottom and drag them in, and maybe say, I don't want that one, and I do want that one. So I'm just swapping these around, and I just get the particular icons that I want. Or you can just go back to just one. It's entirely up to you. Chat notifications on is a good idea. Mail notifications, that just gives you a little message when a little pop-up message will appear when a new message arrives in your inbox. If you like that sort of thing, you can turn that on. There's also the ability to have only the important mail notifications come up. And Gmail will actually, over time, start to determine what it considers to be important mail based on who you get it from and how often you get it from them. So I would just turn it on. You can select a picture. I won't do that right now, but you can select a picture so that when you email somebody, a little icon of your face comes up next to it. A lot of people are not so keen on that idea, but as someone on the early adopter program said to me the other day, it makes a lot of sense in such a big school where not everybody knows everybody. To have a little picture that comes up next to your mail is actually a pretty smart idea. So I would encourage you to actually do that. Not compulsory, but I'd encourage it. The people widget, I think it's a good idea. I would show it. You can turn it off if you don't want it. It just basically gives you a list next to each email message of all the people who were included in that email thread. So if it's like going out to multiple people, you'll be able to see clearly who those people are. The create contacts for autocomplete will allow you to, when you send a new message, it will add them to your contacts list so that when you next type in their name, it will just pop up as soon as you start typing the first few letters of their name. Down here is where you put a signature file, and I will do a separate one of these screencasts to show you how to do the signature file, because it'll take a couple of minutes to do that, but it's not a big deal, and I'll show you how to do that in a separate message. Down below, you've got the ability to show level indicators, snippets, and look, honestly, there's a whole bunch of stuff here that you can pretty much leave as is. You don't need to change anything. We'll just point out the vacation responder. If you go away on holidays and you'd like to leave your message in here so that if someone emails you, they get an automatic reply letting them know that you're on holidays or that you're unable to answer your email for some reason, you can fill that in here and you can determine when it starts and how long it goes for and who sees it. And so that's kind of a useful thing there. Once you've chosen all your settings here under the General tab, you can click the Save Changes button and it will save those changes. Okay, it's given me the option here. Would I also like to make UK English your language for other Google sites? Sure, why not? So I said yes to that. And the page will reload again. Okay, so we've made some changes to the general settings. I'm going to go back into settings again. So I click on the little cogwheel, go back to mail settings, because there are a few other things I'd like to change. So I'm back here in settings, and this time I'm going to go over here to web clips. Web clips They're kind of like little ads that appear on the top of your mail page, and I'm guessing you probably don't want them any more than I don't want them. So you can come in here and just untick this box and they will not bother you anymore. So you can turn those off. Of course, if it turns out they are the sort of things you enjoy, then obviously you can turn it on. It's up to you. After you've turned that off, I would come across here to the Themes tab across the top here. Click on Themes. And as you can see, Gmail here is kind of pretty vanilla. It's white with kind of a grey tinge to it, and that's standard. But if you wanted to, and entirely up to you, you can click on any of these buttons up here to give it a colour tint. So, for example, you might like this mustard colour. And when you click on that, it will go away and it will replace the background colour there with mustard, and when you go back to your inbox, you'll see you'll have some colour on the page. Is that a big deal? Probably not, but it brightens up your email a little bit, and it's, you know, a lot of people prefer that to just staring at a white page. Down below that, there are some high-definition themes, and these ones are photographic themes. So if I pick on this one called Beach, for example, and click that, it will actually load pictures of beaches and all sorts of summery scenes into the background. You can see there's a picture of an umbrella against the sky there. And if I, when I eventually move this this panel in front here, you'll be able to see the rest of the picture. So you can go through and you can pick any of those themes. There's also some what they call classic themes down the bottom here, and have a play with them. Try them out, see which ones you like. If you don't like any of them, you can come back up at top here and click on the one called Light, and that's just the standard plain vanilla Gmail theme. We'll just point out, if you look very carefully in the bottom, well, actually, if you look at this little triangle in the bottom of these colour patches, what this is saying to you is, say this lavender one, for example, that lavender will be the background colour and the panels will be white. This one here, this aubergine one, the background will be this sort of aubergine colour and the panels will be dark. So you have the option of having, you know, a darker look or a lighter look. You've also got, if you look carefully in the corners here, you've got, this is these three little boxes, and some of them have a little picture of a clock, and some of them have a little picture of a sun. What that's telling you is that if you pick one of these themes with the three little boxes, that represents a calendar, and so every day it will put a new photograph in the background for you. Every calendar change, every day change. If you pick one with a clock in the corner, it will change the picture in the background according to the time of day. So this one here of the ocean, for example, if you pick that, then in the early part of the day, you'll get like a sunrise over the ocean. In the middle of the day, you'll have kind of a blue skies and blue ocean. And in the evening, you'll have the sun setting over the ocean. And down some of them that have a little sun picture are actually tied to your location. So if I was to pick this one called Bus Stop, for example, it would ask me where I am. I'll just put in there Sydney. It's actually going to then go out and look up what the weather is in Sydney at the moment, and it's going to replace the background. There you go. It's replaced the background. And it's actually, it's been a sunny day today. Very few clouds, and you can see it's replaced the graphic in the back of the picture with a sunny day and very few clouds. If it was raining, I'd actually have a picture of rain in the background. So it's just a bit of fun there for setting your themes. So they're the main things I would be setting up once you come into your Gmail for the very first time.